Hello everybody, it's nice to see you again at this moment on the one side for presenting about online learning at distance learning and this and the guide Dr. Lazim Muzamil. As we end the entitled From Memorable to Transformative Learning Experience, Theory and Practice of Experience Design. That combining by the Virgin California State University, Los Angeles, USA. Okay, next, the abstract. And this chapter reviews the current state of the theory and practice of experience design and suggests that the notion of experience should be regarded as an essential and unifying theme in guiding a broader perspective of design and study of e-learning. By looking at the learning through the prism of experience design, we may begin to discover ways to create compelling, memorable, and transformative e-learning experience. Some exciting models and effective practice in education are considered as viable models for adapting experience design to a learning context. The introduction in 1999 in an article that entitled Online Education as Interactive Experience. Some guiding models in learning classified as that should be carefully considered by educators. All aspects of education are imbued with a high potential for remembrance and nostalgia. But how does this experience change as experiences more and more from a physical location to cyberspace? In the article, McLean discussed some guiding models and concepts for creating engaging and memorable online learning experience. Experience economy, Pine and Gilmore in 1999, digital storytelling, social presence, and personal space and affordance. How has learning evolved? The term experience as learning is becoming a popular from learning training both in corporate and academic settings. Many authors have contributed to discussion of relevant topics. It suggests that the concept of experience should be regarded as an essential and unifying theme in guiding the design and study of e-learning. Then they consider some exciting models and effective practice in education, including project-based learning. That's we know PBL, knowledge building, visual thinking, and cognitive apprenticeships for creating highly participatory e-learning experience that are not only memorable, but also transformative. That experience design, what can be done to improve the aesthetic of the experience? And the aesthetic are what make your guys want to come and sit down and hang out. Think about what you can do to make an environment more inviting, interesting, and comfortable. You want to create a atmosphere in which your guys feel free to be. Once there, what should your guys do? This escapist aspect of an experience draw your guests further, immersing them in activities. Focus on what you should encourage guests to do if they are to become active participants in the experience. The educational aspect of an experience like the escapist and essentially active learning, as it is not largely understood, requires the full participation of learner. What do you want to guys to learn from the experience, and what information of activities will help to engage them to exploration of knowledge and skill? Entertainment like aesthetic is a basic aspect of an experience. When your guys are entertained, they are not really doing anything but responding to enjoying, laughing, and the experience. What can you do, by the way, by entertainment futures and the experience realm adapted from Pine and Gilmore 1999 of 405 from memorable to transformative learning. Experience to get your guests to stay. How can you make experience more fun and more enjoyable? Depend on the motivation as an experience design, Spitzer 1999 reminds us to consider that the nature of the task and the context in all types of activities. He explained the text-based activity. The context is everything else. It is interesting to note that most tasks are inherently boring or will eventually become that way if they are repeated long enough. He suggests that instructional designer consider inclusion of the following motivators in a learning context: action, fun, variety, choice, and social interaction, error tolerance, measurement, feedback, challenge, and recognition. Des Spence in 1994 found that flow experience is designed with lightly individual exploratory computer use. We share with challenge and feeling a sense of being controlled. These findings are consistent with yearly studies on computer games, suggesting that the challenge, fantasy, curiosity, and control are important factors associated with for our switch from memorable to transformative e-learning experience intrinsically motivating environment. Taken together, experience designers should consider that the following motivator: enjoyment, concentration, exploration, challenge, control, action, fun, variety, cost, social interaction, error tolerance, measurement, feedback, recognition, fantasy, curiosity, cooperation, competition, and recognition. E-learning and experience design. E-learning is no doubt a design that's experience-looking learning, so it's primes of experience design. Where do we begin to create engaging and memorable e-learning experience? Finally, more 99 suggests that the first step would be envision a well-defined incorporation concept from drama, share, and storytelling. McLean expands on about the approach that they offer the following design elements for adaptive experience design education. Theme, the stories, and then star takeaway and dramatic, yes? What the thematic here means, what the sequence learning activities so that there is a clear trajectory of beginning, middle, and the end. And then dramatic strategies, including sequence progression and duration of event and rhythm on tempo. Experience clues, design, environmental boundaries, concentrate. And then this practical approach is useful in following aspects. Embracing teaching techniques with as ops, both the content delivery, process designer, and psychological needs, and then open and opposite to escalate content and motivator in learning process. PBL as an experience design for education, PBL can be defined as the systematic teaching method that engages students in learning knowledge and skills through an extended inquiry. A process structure around complex authentic question and carefully designed product and text. It has much in common with the other text approach such as problem-based learning. Then Krejcik, Blumenfeld, Marx, Soloway have encapsulated that the essence of PBL with the following five features. The first means a driving question or problem that set the scene for the project. And then students' concentration and an artifact and presentation to an outside audience. And then students' collaborative research often over an extended period of time, community of inquiry, and use the technology-based cognitive and communication tools. Technology and experience design. Undoubtedly, the technology can provide a powerful means of cognitive and social aspect of learning design. While there are many developments in learning, of particular relevance of the theme discussed so far is a new way using technologies as community tools. And it's important to consider as so many questions have been raised concerning teaching and learning in today's ever-changing digital landscape. And then the importance of cognitive PBL, integrating visual and thinking and cognitive apprenticeship for transformative learning. There are some projects. It is very important to increase complexity in projects by dealing with typical learner difficulties, such as conceptually and difficulty for knowledge and knowledge transfer and self-regulation. Specifying a set of cognitive and metacognitive goals and scaffolding student use and development of effective cognitive metacognitive skills. In this regard, Tedge suggested that creative of use technology can be very effective in helping students escape from their passive and habitually learning patterns. The first step necessary to both active and transformative learning technology, both as a tool and outlet, can make learner developing understanding visible by opening ideas, through processes and structure of knowledge for critical examination and assessment relevant by McLean. Okay, and then on the basis of cognitive PBL, there are general principles have been suggested to guide design of online PBL experience. The first means integrating visual thinking and cognitive efficiency for transformative learning, and then staging experiences with the milestone effect and engaging groups experience with knowledge building tasks. At this time, the experience design is the theory and practical evidence be more conceptual than empirical and well-integrated experience design. Model for learning is yet to be fully explored and developed nevertheless. The concept of experience should be viewed and essential in unifying them in guiding a broader perspective of design of study and learning. In some converging areas, research from the field of experience design education have been identified not to reinvent the wheel but expand our knowledge and design the quality and learning experience that will be valued people. We should continue to look into the other parts of the study and we sometimes continue to explore exciting model and practice in education that be adapted for transformative learning experience design. What is studying experience with milestone artifact? In using VBL, visual thinking and cognitive experiences as a design foundation, the transformative experience can be elicited and mediated by various milestone artifacts. And how to enhance group experience knowledge by building the text. The social and emotional dynamic of the knowledge building culture can be a powerful motivator to engage participants in international, focused and collaborative learning process with peers. And similar to the function of a milestone artifact, the text of knowledge building can also be viewed as a form of a digital storytelling and embodied collaborative knowledge representation. And then social plans and social space, this intensive process can permit the creation of a full-fledged learning community where individuals can overcome their isolation and draw benefit from interaction with code. However, there's considerable differences in small groups pattern of interaction that need to be considered. Notably, in dealing with the complex text under the constraint of exciting learning tools, most participants prefer to meet face-to-face instead communicating online. And then the active communication among the participants is a critical component developing online knowledge by building communities. On the contrary, online learners feel most distance and disconnect or confused when while waiting for responses from others. And then it is Jones and Krenz, 2005, pointed out that communication is essential but not a sufficient condition for collaborative learning. According to them, collaboration in any environment, face-to-face online, provided a set of challenges that require much more than simply placing participants in a group. Because collaboration is a social act, learning environment needs to be conducted ensuring participant learning performance as well as social performance. Moreover, social interaction will not take place automatically, but need be elicited by certain conditions. Example of condition that compel collaboration include group members depending on a teacher and helping one another success while they are held responsible for their own part of their work. And this side enables social performance has important implication for using DBL as a framework for a learning process design. DBL design should be considered here. The first area really focus on the structure of participants. Related studies include creating social structure to promote participant and sense of agency, providing activity structure as action-based activities and discourse-based activities. Use dialogic effectively structures to guide discourse activities. The future in search of quality experience in the digital landscape. Experience in the digital landscape, the first means the online learning environment should be viewed as another physical space for us to apply what we already know about effective teaching and learning. And then it is a productive to view online learning as an example of student learning from experience. According to them, key that features that enhance learning from the online experience include establishment of the climate for learning that values the learner, active engagement with problems and challenges, effective and responsive, and simulation of rich environment and peer discussion. In addition to this feature, this chapter extends the discussion to consider some educational model and practice for adapting experience design a learning context. Below are some ways to cover Pine and Gilmer Rim's experience in learning environment. Studying this growth include making interest of the learning environment more inviting, intuitive and useful, and the design of look and feel visual presentation. Okay, from the memorable transformative learning experience and the learning environment. The ultimate goal this realm that we ensure that your learners enjoy coming back to the learning environment. Of course, in addition, learning activities can be designed so that the learners can share personal experience in the form of storytelling using various multimedia elements. Educational, this require the learners to effectively absorb the information and instruction presented. Appropriate instructional strategies such as cooperative learning and problem-based learning can be used to design the learning experience. Entertainment, and this is a passive affect aspect of an experience where relevant illustration, such as comic strips, quotable quotes, or even sharing fun experience will be used to make the learning experience more fun and enjoyable. This directive for the Alban, Alexander, Baron, and Biro. Okay, I think that's all for this presentation about the online and distance learning under guidance Dr. Lasim Musamil. Thank you very much. Hopefully this is can be useful by each person. Thank you.